Hey there, YouTube, it's me, Superkook, coming to you guys today with episode 5 of my Blind Golden Sun Let's Play. The last part we got here, and Kraiden over here gave us 5 mythical bag thingies, and he told us to go grab the stone thingies, I guess, or something along the lines of that. He guess he couldn't do it because it was too slippery or something, but he wants me to do it, but whatever. Alright, I don't know if I'm supposed to be grabbing these in any particular order. I can't get to them. I don't know how to get to them. I really hope this isn't like the last part where I spent 20 minutes solving a puzzle that just took me like 6 seconds. So, oh my god, I spent the entire episode solving one puzzle and I realized that puzzle was not that hard in hindsight. Alright, I think I got it. Here we go. That works. Alrighty then. Guess I was supposed to collect them in some kind of order then. I believe the Venus Star, I believe that was the Earth one. Fetch the others. Yeah, I did notice that the 4 stones were actually the same elements in Avatar: The Last Airbender. It kind of made me chuckle a little bit. I can go grab the water one up here. So far, so good. Not taking 20 minutes. And let's go pop that up. And probably another one up over here. Alright, cool. Seriously, this game looks great for the Game Boy. This game, I don't know, it looks really cool. I don't know, I just think it looks cool. Mercury Star. Good, gonna fetch it. Are you gonna tell me that every time? But yeah, part of me hopes this kind of works like the materia in Final Fantasy VII. I'm probably gonna drop some blasphemy on you guys here right now, but I actually did not enjoy Final Fantasy VII as much as everybody else does. But the materia system worked pretty okay, so I kind of hope that the stones here kind of work like that, where I just kind of can mix and match the magic that I want to use. I kind of want to use Earth magic, because, like, Avatar: The Last Airbender, I love Earthbenders, and, like, ugh, you know? That's how I feel about Earthbenders, that noise right there that I did. Yeah. Alright, here's the air one. No. There you go. Sorry if you guys can hear that, I was scratching my neck and that thing. Alright, here's the air stone. The air one was purple, I remember that much. Hopefully we actually get some combat in this episode, because we actually didn't get any at all in the last episode, because I spent the entire time failing. Why can't I move? What's happening? Oh, it's those dudes. They're back. Bad guys, I think. I don't know, this is an RPG, they might be a good guy or something, because I guess they were part of this other evil organization or something. Who is that? That's a third person. We won't hurt you. Those two hurt me. The two in the front, they knocked me out in the first episode, or was it the first, second episode, or something like that? I don't know. I guess they made some sort of agreement to not hurt us. I'm not handing them over. I want to use them. Am I supposed to go grab the last one then? Alright. Yeah. Wait, no, I meant to say no. I mean, yes. Oops, I didn't mean to skip that. Whoa, Felix, what? Didn't he die in the first episode? That is what he said. He did say Felix. Pretty sure he did die. was pulling some kind of Darth Vader on here. Okay then, that was... That actually did kind of catch me off guard a little bit. I do like the nice little plot twists like that. Wow, I guess he did not die. Okay then. You don't say. Sorry, I'm kind of reading the text. I apologize for that. So, to my understanding, those guys are part of this evil organization or something, and Felix, I guess, survived the boulder, and I guess he kind of joined them, or they picked him up, and he kind of joined them. So I guess, I don't know if he's, like, evil now or something. I don't know. Whatever. Okay. I probably should go grab the last one before giving you guys the first three. Yeah, we probably should. Now, slow down, that's only three of the four. There's still the fourth one up there. Okay. Stars, alright. Hopefully I'll be getting him back at some point. Don't apologize in advance. That means you're gonna do something bad. You're gonna smack me, aren't you? Okay. Alrighty. Sorry, I'm just kind of reading the text. There's a lot of story progression going on this episode. Alright, fine. We'll bring you the star. We were trying to go get it, but you decided to ambush us a little bit. Something tells me we're gonna have to fight them. I really hope we have some combat in this episode. I feel like beating something up. Let's go grab the last star, the fire one. And I don't know how to... I can't reach that jump. Alright. Okay, I can't jump that way. I'm gonna have to go, like, all the way around. And then they're just gonna say, hey, bro, what you doing? Okay, sorry, I'm just talking to these real quick. And who are you? Like, you were not here earlier. You just kind of popped out of nowhere. Okay, whatever. Whatever. Sorry, I've been reading way too much Homestuck lately. I don't know how to get that. Seriously. Seriously, what am I doing? I can't jump over there. It's not letting me make that jump. And I can't go around because you guys are all blocking the way. Why you do this, game? Why you do this? Game, why you do this? Alrighty. And I still can't go this way. Like, I can't... Oh. What's up? Don't have anything to say to me? Alright, cool. I don't want to talk to you either. Seriously, where... I don't know where I'm going. I doubt... I don't think I'm going this way, but I'm gonna go this way anyways. Okay, no. Alright, maybe I come up here and around here. No, not around there. Oh, why are there so many little jumping puzzles? My god. There we go, I think I got that. Alright, that makes more sense, and I still have to go around. I want combat, that's what I want. That's what I want. Can you oblige me that? Alright, we got the last star. The fire one. The Mars star. I wouldn't be shocked if you teleported over here just to grab it. Oh, wait. Okay, that's new. Not again. The waters. Alrighty then. Well, that cool-looking area is not looking too cool anymore. Well, it's still looking cool. There's lava and stuff. I think that's lava. And we see an eyeball. Do you not know? Why would I know what it is? It appears to be a rock with an eye. Nah, I don't think that's Cyanergy, because Cyanergy is a lot more colorful than that. Such incredible power. Shock. Wow. Okay, he's the guardian of the stars. Now slow down. Now slow down. Yeah, what about us? We are still there. We will make it out alive. And we have the star, so how about not having us be killed? No, don't take Jenna. She's our fire mage. I like my fire magic. Okay, I guess his name is Alex. Yeah, take Creighton. He's old. He doesn't have much time left anyways. That was kind of dark. I'm sorry. Creighton, you probably have plenty of time left. You don't look a day older than 97. I don't know what we want. I think what I want is to fight something and get out of this area. That's what I want. Yeah. Felix. Can we go now? What about us? Dude's way, way over there. The top. Yeah. Can we make haste? Don't push her. That's mean. Just because you're a girl does not mean you can't. Yeah, Bernardi. Alright. I guess they're taking all of us, and we're just gonna be stuck here. And everybody's walking through the portal, or at least one dude is. If they all go through one at a time, I am going to be very upset. They're going through one at a time, aren't they? Yep. I don't plan on dying, hopefully, otherwise the game would end pretty soon. They did go through one at a time. Fantastic way to take your time with that game. Were we really hiding behind the statue? Were we really hiding behind that statue? It could have turned out worse. We could be dead. It's like Isaac. Was supposed to be. But he's not. No, they seem honorable, if not bad. I mean, he's evil, yeah, but honorable at least. I think they're gonna honor their promise. Okay, I think we need to try to find a way out now. Even though, like, it appears some of the rocks are gone. Yeah, okay. We need to make it out of the situation alive. So that way we continue the game. Yeah, we are in big trouble, yes, because we have to fight the rock thingy. Why is it looking at us? I think it knows that we're not bad guys. This place has become dangerous. It's talking to us. The eye is talking to us. It seems to be sentient. It seems to kind of be able to tell the difference between right and wrong and know that we are not evil and trying to... I don't even know why we were collecting the stars in the first place, but whatever. And he's gonna hold the volcano for- Thank you, Mr. I. I appreciate that so much. We will leave. What is that? What did it do? The elemental djinn, they've returned. Yeah, sure, let's take out the star. Well... Okay. But, like... The thing is, it only happened when all four of the stars were taken out, so maybe if we put the one back, the water will come back and stuff, because it didn't really start draining the water and volcanoes until all four of the stars were out, so I don't know. So I'm guessing that's going to be kind of the plot around this game, is revolving around getting the elemental stars back here, I believe. So, that sounds like it could be a fun storyline. Alright. Whoa, yeah, can we stop making casual conversation and go? I appreciate everything you're doing, Mr. Eyeball, I really do. I appreciate you stopping the volcano from erupting and killing us. You know, we already had one Darth Vader, we don't need another, because he died in episode 3 because of the thingy in the lava. Which is kind of funny, because you would not die like that in lava. You would not have part of your body slowly melt away. That's not how lava works. Lava is ridiculously hot. If you were to ever fall in lava, I think it's going to help us get out. But if we were ever to fall in lava, essentially all of the water in your body would immediately boil and turn into, gas, and you would explode. Like, that's just what would happen. You wouldn't melt. You would explode. It did save us, but you would explode immediately, and will probably cause a mini eruption because you're moving the lava around and stuff. And yeah, that's how lava works. Yeah, let's go. Let's make haste. I don't remember how to get out of here. I swear if there are random encounters, I will, like, punch a baby. Because I want combat that's not a little mouse or something. And for the record, I am not afraid to punch a baby. I will punch a baby in the throat. I have done it before. No, I'm kidding. I have never punched a baby, and I, for the time being, do not plan on punching any babies. I'm just going to leave it at that. That's down. And it's... We're not going in here, are we? Okay. Alright. Run. I don't really think we're in a time limit or anything. Oh yeah, I remember this. This is the first puzzle that we just... Alright, cool. We are out of there. There's the blue area. I'm glad that there's no random encounters. That would kind of ruin the tension of this moment. Music's pretty cool here, too. Run, forest, run. Yeah, I'm kind of upset that it's all been more puzzles. I'm kind of upset that there's been no combat at all in the last two episodes. I apologize for that. Yeah, because I am probably going to have to end up the part pretty soon, because it's been almost 20 minutes of story progression. Did it explode? It's in the process of exploding. There's that. I thought Mount Aleph was inactive. Yeah, Garrett is the cause of this eruption, and it's his fault. Yep, we did go to Kraydon's house. Yeah, the source of alchemy is in the eruption. So, yeah. Let's nonchalantly act like we had nothing to do with this. We probably shouldn't go back up, because we probably will die immediately. Oh, they see us. Okay. Isaac. Yay, yeah, we are safe. Barely. You guys should have seen it. there was a giant eyeball, and there was a volcano, and there are people of multiple colors, and Garrett and Isaac, and then Felix isn't dead, and then Darth Vader in lava, volcano, explosions, no, they weren't. Not the whole time, at least. Yeah, they were taken away. We need to call Liam Neeson. That's what we need to do. Liam Neeson will... I'll tell you exactly what happened. Come into the sanctum, both of you. This is gonna be a long bit of dialogue, so I really hope I have an opportunity to save, like, right quick, real quick. And then we can start the song the next... Aw, man. Okay, cool. I'm not gonna have to scroll through a bunch of dialogue. They're just gonna silently tell you everybody what's going on and show the... I believe the Mars Star was the name of the Fire Star. I'm gonna pantomime everything like Kurt's a cowardly dog. Perfectly. Nod, jump. Just do everything you need to do and they will understand everything. And run in circles, yes. Yes, that is the perfect pantomiming right there. That's almost as bad as Super Mario RPG pantomiming. We had no idea the true sanctum. Well, that's because you didn't look. You guys forbid people from looking in there, and you don't even know what's going on. I guess they're prisoners. Of course they'll be saved because Jenna has party animations, and I doubt they'd give her party animations and a health bar and a title, the Flame Mage user thingy or whatever, for, like, six random encounters. I really doubt that. A hovering stone, something about a rock. Rock Man. Mega Man. Oh my god, I am terrible at Mega Man games. I don't know if I'm bad or if they're just extremely hard. I've heard the latter, that they're just really hard. Like, Mega Man 2, oh my god, I just got bored one day and I started playing it. And I didn't want to quit, and I was just getting really... really angry, and I guess we're talking about the oddball right now. How did you talk to the Great One? Isn't he an eyeball? Stop the explosion, volcano of destruction of doom. Anyways, will the volcano destroy Vale? Probably. Vale was already destroyed by Falling Rock earlier, so... yeah, we probably... this place does not seem like a safe place to... Vale will be safe. The wise one prevent the lava from reaching us. Okay. This does not seem like a safe place to live. I have seen giant typhoon rocks falling, you know, people dying, volcano. No. Something even more dreadful. What can be worse than destruction of a lot of things? The Holocaust? That's worse than destruction of Vale. Racist. I'm just kidding. I do a lot of dark humor. I like dark humor. Probably because I have dark skin. If you guys don't know, I'm black. I'm really just kind of half reading this text. I probably should read it. It's probably important. But I do have a general idea of what's going on. The wise one wants us to get all these stones back. So that the planet and Vale won't be destroyed, and they start to destroy itself because of the thing. And yeah, almost 25 minutes of pure dialogue. Man, this episode. So apparently it's our job now to get the elemental stars. Yep, probably. Garrett is only a child. Yeah, this is an RPG. Kids do this stuff all the time in RPGs. Duh. Alright, so it is our job to save the world now. Me decide. I will... yeah, sure, of course. Let's do it, guys. This is Golden Sun. No, I mean it. I mean it. I like that. He said, you decide. And then I decide. He's like, wait, what? And he's like, nope, you gave him the decision. Give him the decision. Alright. I'm giving the commands now? Okay. Hi, wise one. Well, nice to see you again. Should be watching the thing. Alrighty. I really wanted some combat in this episode, honestly. But whatever, there will hopefully be combat in the next episode. I mean, if you've never played Golden Sun, you could probably watch this with me if you guys are going through this blind with me. But if you have, you guys might just want to skip this episode because chances are if you've beaten the game, you know the story. I don't know the story, so I have to go through all this, but yeah. So, I can't necessarily assume that the hex is going to end soon, but I kind of do want to end the part because it's been nearly a half an hour of recording Golden Sun. Gosh. Seek the elementals, the djinn. They will provide useful. Okay. Isn't there anything else? Probably. That's all? Does that mean you're done with the text? Nope. You can't tell me anything because it's my job, you know? I know what to do. I can handle this. Leaving it all up to me. I got this. We just gotta go. That's how RPGs work. You just do it. It's one of those tasks that you just have to do it, like pulling weeds, you know, it may be annoying and monotonous, but you just gotta do it, and that's the only way to get it done. They have to meditate? Meditate, yep, okay, I'll see you guys later. Those are, I believe, our parents, or something like that. No, we can handle this. Don't worry about it. Thank you, Sam. Of course I didn't, because it was an RPG, and you always have to leave the fate up of the world to, like, 12 to 17-year-old boys. That's just how RPGs work. I think Japan has a ridiculous amount of faith in, 12 to 13-year-old boys. Or 12 to 17, or whatever I said earlier. Alrighty. And I believe that is a healing jingle, meaning, yay, we all got healed, and I really hope they don't put us through more text. Are you serious? There's been that, like, literally a half an hour straight of text in this game. I mean, I don't mind scrolling stuff, but when I'm on YouTube, I don't want to sit through scrolling text, because I just want to play the game. I mean, maybe I should have picked an RPG if I was going to do something blind, but whatever. I don't mind text. I know I sound like I'm annoyed, but yeah, I'm not that annoyed. So far, the story's actually pretty interesting to my, just from what I've seen so far. It feels like it could be cool, but I'm just waiting for the open-worldness of RPGs to begin, you know, because that's part of my favorite part. You know, I love story, like, you know, story can really make or break a game for me, but I don't know. And, like, what I really enjoy in the RPGs is just going to the open world and just, you know what I mean? Just kids and doggies. Oh, don't say goodbye. Like, that's more text. That's, oh my god. Everybody is here. We are counting on, okay. Don't drink the water if it smells funny. Take this with you too. Herb, yeah, that's a base healing item equivalent to like a potion or something. I know not to drink stagnant water. Don't listen to him. He's a pig. Eat anything that's not tied down. I mean, I'm the same way. I mean, like, one time I saw a bird, and it was flying, and I jumped 60 feet in the air, and I ate it, because I was hungry. I get more things. The catch beats, what do those do? I guess we're all set to go. Think again. Nope. Okay, more text. All right. Where is my mom, by the way? I would assume that she doesn't want me to go, seeing as she's my mom. But, maybe she'll be like the mom in Black and White 2, where she's just like, alright, get out! I know you just turned 10, but bye! Alright, farewell. We will go on a journey, starting in the next episode. I believe I can save here. So I will see you guys all later. This has been episode, something of Golden Sun, episode whatever. I'll see you guys all later. Sorry for the long episode. Comment, like, subscribe. I'll see you guys all later again. Bye-bye.